Hey guys, HDV here, and welcome back to another Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield rumor video. Today's video is actually pretty exciting because this rumor goes into basically all the big announcements for Sword and Shield, all about the trailers dropping and everything like that. Of course, it is just a rumor though, so take it with a grain of salt. This isn't confirmed true or false. Just take it with a grain of salt, right? It's just a rumor. It's a pretty cool one. We have a lot of information, like I say, about when things are going to get released. So, yeah, if any of these do get released, then we know this is all completely true. But anyway, if you guys are excited for the video, drop a like down below. It really does help out. Leave a comment as well. Which game are you getting? Getting Pokemon Sword and Shield or what? Starter Pokemon you're going to be picking as well. You're going to be picking Sobble, Scorbunny, or Grookey. Subscribe as well if you're brand new because we do daily Pokemon content on this channel. With all of that out of the way, let's get into the video and take a look at apparently when we're going to be getting some new information about Sword and Shield. So starting things off, Big Boy 19 is his name. Big Boy 19 says, don't want to reveal too much information. I've got a source who has some inside information on the games. He knows some vague things about the game, and he knows anything that's going to be revealed pre-release from the trailers and the dates of the trailers. He only has the English names of some Pokemon, though, namely the evolutions that are being revealed. Any signature moves or abilities are direct Japanese translations, so the English versions might be different. So there's a lot to go over, to be fair, so it's going to be a lot of talking, a lot of information, just like pow, pow, pow. It's just going to be like Oprah, but you know, you get some information, you get some information. You're at the back, get some information. Anyway, Friday, March 22nd. So today is the 13th. Friday, the 22nd of March is in like, what, two, like a week on Friday. So a week on Friday, we're apparently supposed to get a trailer today according to a different rumor. I don't think we're going to get one today, so that rumor is kind of false. But apparently, a week on Friday, we're going to be getting this. Both legendary Pokemon revealed. There's a lot of information shown to them, so bear with me. And surprisingly, two wolves, one based on offensive, while the other is based on defense. Well, I'm just assuming based on their designs, and well, it's obvious. Fighting Rock for the Sword Legendary, and Fighting Steel for the Shield. Their abilities are called Vicious Blade and Unficing Bastion, respectively. Although, again, those are the direct Japanese translations, so they're probably going to have different names. Now, when I read that, I feel like he's just kind of covering his own tracks. Like, okay, yeah, I might have got the Japanese wrong, so if it is different, that's why. So I feel like that's just him covering his tracks. So this might not be completely accurate, but Vicious Blade seems to be substantially increased the power of physical moves, while Unflinching Bastion substantially reduces damage by physical moves. Just a guess, though. My source says he can't tell for sure what was in the trailer. Ironic. Their signature moves are shown in the trailer, being Unstoppable Strike and Impenetrable Shield. That raises defense by two stages and the special defense by one stage. And the sword, the former is shown to an obvious rock sword move that goes through protecting moves and increases attack by one stage. So the defensive one is definitely better because you basically increase the defense by two stages and the special defense by one stage, and all the physical attack does is one stage. So it also allowed the user to not flinch or be switched out if it is used that turn. It seems they're both designed to be extremely powerful based on these OP moves, probably because they're, you know, legendaries. Just a guess. November 22nd release date shown along with the box art. Liepard, Vigoroth, and Oranguru, and probably Persimmon by extension lines are all confirmed here. So November 22nd does make sense because, as I was saying in a previous video, they always release it on the third Friday of the month. And, well, no, the third Friday is the 15th, the fourth Friday is the 22nd. So they've always released it on the third Friday, but this one's apparently on the fourth one. A lot of people are saying the 22nd of November. Like, all these rumors are saying the 22nd of November. So if any of these rumors are correct, maybe that. Because obviously, the first Friday of November is the 1st of November. So maybe they're just not going to count that one, and they're just going to do the fourth this time. Then says, on Tuesday, April the 9th, a regional bird, rodent, and bug are revealed. Pretty standard. Rodent is based on a hamster, normal. That was in the Pokedex that apparently went over yesterday, so who knows? The bird is based on a canary flying, and the bug is based on a ladybug. This trailer also shows a lot more of the region. Also, the new professor is shown. She's a woman. She researches Pokemon breeding. Eevee shown in the trailer, but he was a given anyway. On the Saturday, the April the 27th, we're going to get, I take another trailer. Meltan gets a trailer dedicated to him. There's an area in the game called Meltan Grotto, again, direct Japanese translation, that has a bunch of Meltans in them. The professor is shown in the trailer giving you a strange Pokemon egg, so that could just be like the Togepi thing in Johto, as the game describes it, in the Meltan Grotto. It is also shown in this Meltan Grotto that Meltan is customizable in terms of stats. The trailer supposedly looks super vague on how it's done, but my source says it kind of looks like a Meltan Chao Garden. Meltan, like a Chao Garden was from Sonic Adventures, I think, where you could basically go and train the Chaos or something like that. I don't know, I haven't played that game in forever. But yeah, it's basically like a massive Chao Garden, and it's basically from Sonic. Whatever that means. So yeah, basically it's going to be like a massive farm of Meltan. Evil team also shown in the trailer, ransacking the Meltan Grotto. They talk about how they want to steal Meltan, but it doesn't seem like it's their main goal. I feel like Meltan is definitely going to be tied into the evil team, though, because there must be something about Meltan that makes them want to collect them all. So on the 3rd of May, which is a Friday, Melmetal gets new forms, a new form for every stat, allegedly dependent on how you raise your Meltan in the Chao Garden thing. Probably the stat of you train the most is what form you get, and it's equal, you just get the normal one. So that'd be really cool. So maybe like a Deoxys kind of throwback. So we have like Deoxys attack, speed, defense, everything like that. This time we have a new Meltan form, or Melmetal form for everything. So if you get like attack, physical attack up the most, you get one form, physical defense up the most form, special attack, and all that. So then it says on the Wednesday, May the 22nd, evolutions for old Pokemon are shown. Pokemon that get evolutions are Dunsparce, Farfetch'd, and Quillfish. Pokemon that get pre-evolutions are Lapras and Buffalon. See, this rumor was kind of... I was kind of believing this rumor until this bit. I don't think we're going to get any evolutions of old Pokemon. Dunsparce, Farfetch'd, and Quillfish. I don't know. I don't think about that. Maybe... I feel like Dunsparce should have always got an evolution, to be fair. It just looked like something that should evolve. The pre-evolutions, I don't think we're going to get those. I would rather have thought we would have got a pre-evolution for Tauros and Miltank, though, instead of Buffalon, because there's a lot of things that do tie Miltank and Tauros together. Anyway, E3 2019. Lots of things shown in a huge trailer. It's basically the smash of this year's E3. Lots more locations of Galar shown and some snippets of story information. Your rival is also revealed. She's your friend like Hal, but she's also pretty competitive and doesn't like to lose, kind of like Sharon. Not overly friendly, but not rude like Blue or anything. So that's a decent rival. I like that it's kind of like in between everything. First two gym masters revealed, poison and ice type. The poison one is shown first, so I assume the poison is the first leader. I don't know if I believe that, because the trailer looked like the first gym was a grass gym. It definitely looked like a leaf. So poison and ice, I don't think that's going to be. Unless we obviously go to the top of the map. But yeah, the bottom of the map, where like it looks like it's the first gym. It looks like a grass gym, so I'm not sure about that. Poison master is shown with a level 15 Ekans, and ice master is shown with a level 24 Snorunt. I take it that gym master thing is just is related to that tweet that came out a few days ago that Nintendo deleted. There are 10 new Pokemon shown. The regional Rodent gets an evolution, which is normal fighting. The regional bird does as well, which is flying normal. And the regional bug, which is bug flying. So starter evolutions also revealed to the second stages, being grass fairy, fire, and water. Grass fairy for Grookey, though? I'm not sure about that. I don't believe that. It doesn't scream fairy at all. Three new evolutions, either the only ones that I have more detailed information on, since they are the go in more detail in the trailer, although I only have one name. Ghost evolution, evolved by the Dust Stone. Okay. Dragon evolution, evolved by speaking to a specific trainer in the Galar region. So apparently we're getting a ghost and a dragon type evolution, or whatever that means. And finally a normal evolution, which I don't know for sure, but it just might be called Eon. This evolution has a special ability called Neutrality. It is not weak to, immune to, or resistant to any move. It also has a signature move with a name that's made up, so I don't know how to translate it. It's a rainbow laser of sorts that does neutral damage to every type, even ghost, and gets bonus stab. The third legendary is shown, seems to be based off of a Pegasus. All that's shown is its typing, fairy fighting. I refuse to believe that we are going to get new evolutions and one of them is not going to be a steel type. For Pokemon games called Sword and Shield, I refuse to believe we are not going to get a steel type evolution. I just do not believe it at all. We must be getting a steel type evolution. We have to be. And it also makes sense as well, being that the last evolution we got was a fairy type. They always get released as like being good against one being good against the other. Steel's good against fairy. I can't see us. Maybe the dragon type, obviously, because it's England, but I feel like we should be getting dragon and steel. If I was gonna put my money on it, I would say we're gonna get a dragon and steel evolution, just because dragon is obviously linked to old England mythology and obviously the flag of Wales, and then, like I say, the steel because it's sword and shield. Wednesday, July the 17th, some new Pokemon as well as new evolutions shown. Regional bird and bug get final evolutions, being flying, psychic, and bug fairy. So apparently, the two Pokemon that you get at the very start both have two evolutions, which is cool. More Pokemon get evolutions. Corsola, Water, Rock, and Torkoal. Maractus gets a pre-evolution. Nah, I don't believe this. New pseudo-legendary shown based off of a Griffin. Pure Flying. Its evolution is Ocean, which is Flying Ground. Torkoal getting an evolution. Torkoal won't get an evolution. It just won't. Maractus will not get a pre-evolution. Why Maractus? Maractus is such a... It's just such a forgettable Pokemon. Nobody is going to want that. Corsola, I mean, maybe. Maractus, I highly doubt it. I always thought that Maractus should have been like the female evolution of Cacnea, and then Cacturne should have been the male. Wednesday, July 24th, the final stage of the pseudo-legendary is shown, still flying ground. August 15th, miscellaneous new Pokemon showing they're based off of a dolphin, elephant, manticore, and peacock, water, grass, ground, dark, fairy, and poison type respectively. More information on evil teams. These have tradition versus innovation theme with two different teams, like in Ruby and Sapphire. So I guess that could be like the House Sword and House Shield thing that we saw from that Ruby, the rumor ages ago. August 24th. I can't see us getting information this quickly though. There's literally like a week between these. Literally, these three things, a week between, like 2 weeks between all of them. I don't think that. So on the September the 2nd, more information on the third legendary, Fairy Fighting, as stated before, with an ability called Neutralized Force, which ignores all stat changes to the opponent. Signature move called Something Made Up, so I can't give proper translation, but it's a strong special attacking move that resets opponent's stats and increases special attack defense of user by one stage. It's a fairy move, but it's super effective against the Shield legendary regardless. That is super broken. 15th of October, one day before my birthday, these new gym masters shown. Dark shown with Scrafty, Normal shown with the evolution of the regional rodent, and Flying showing Farfetch'd evolution. Evil team leader shown. More information on your rival. New mysterious character who looks kind of like AZ. It might be him, but I have no idea. Four new Pokemon shown, which are the Pikachu clones, something that I have no idea what it is. It's the Spider-Man's evolution. Electric Fighting, Fire Ice, Bug Poison. I can't see us getting shown like the evil teams, the evil team leaders, a month before the games come out. Because they're coming out in November. I can't see us getting... Yeah, I don't know, man. Thursday the 31st of October, new Pokemon shown. Normal Ghost, doesn't seem to be based off of anything in particular. November the 4th, final evolutions for the starter shown. I don't know, man. Water Dragon, Grass Fairy, Fire Electric. Grass Fairy, I can't see that happening, man. More information on your rival won't spoil it. It's story related. And then on release day, Mythical Pokemon event revealed lasts until November the 29th. But will become available to everyone who missed out in January. Steel Fighting. Lasts until November 29th, but will become available to everyone who missed out in January. I can't see them... No, they're not going to make an event last a week. They're just not. There are lots of new, more Pokemon and new evolutions aren't shown in the trailers, and I probably missed some things like new features, but that's this information I have. There could be two trailers in my stores, haven't had the revealed new features or something. I don't know how much I believe about this. I mean, I believed it all until we kind of got into the pre-evolutions and stuff. I feel like we will not be getting information this quickly. Three trailers in 2 weeks just doesn't seem like something Pokemon would do. And I don't know, man. The evolution, I don't know. The pre-evolution from Rattata? Nah, man. I don't know. Personally, I think this is just a load of hocus pocus. But that is this rumor. So yeah, I don't know what I feel about that one. I don't think it's true at all. But yeah, again, this is just a discussion for you guys. What do you guys think about this rumor? I think it'd be cool if it was true, but I don't know. That is going to be everything, though. If you did enjoy, drop a like, leave a comment as well if you did enjoy, and of course, subscribe as well if you're brand new, because I do daily Pokemon content on this channel. That is everything from me, though, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Have an amazing rest of your day. Until next time, peace.